Hello everyone, this is Aditya and I'm back with another video. Today we are going to see the updates on international flight ban extended till November 30. Along with it, we are also going to see the latest update in the exception category of the new travel policy, which has been announced on October 25th for the people who are traveling to US starting November 8th. And add on to it, we are also going to see the heads up given by US Embassy India that we can expect significant appointment wait times for few non-immigrant to visa category. So what it means for the people who are waiting to get their stamping done in the month of November and December. So for all that, let's get into the video. After the announcement of India extending the international flight ban till November 30, there were a lot of confusions going on. Actually, you have to make a note of the word extended, which means this international flight ban is in place for the past 1 year. And to be more precise, it is there since the start of the pandemic. And since then, the travelers were traveling in the flights which falls under the air bubble agreement. And those flights are in operations and it is going to be in operation till further announcement. And moreover, we can expect more number of schedules to be added under the air bubble agreement as US have announced that they are going to lift the travel ban starting November 8th. And if you see the number of travelers who traveled to India under the air bubble agreement in the past 1 year is approximately 2.8 million people, and the number of travelers who traveled from India to other countries is approximately 2.2 million people. So I think this would give you a confidence that there is no issue in traveling. You can go ahead with your plans for November and December. After the announcement of new travel policy by the White House and CDC on October 25th, now on October 30th, CDC has updated the exception criteria for children who are not eligible to get vaccinated. First, let us see what was there in the exception criteria when the new travel policy was announced, and later we will see what has been updated. The exception criteria which they have mentioned in the new travel policy which was announced on October 25th are the children who are not eligible to get vaccinated and traveling with the parents should provide an attestation to the airlines before boarding. And in the attestation, they should have mentioned that they are agreeing to take the viral test within 3 to 5 days of their arrival to US. And they will self-quarantine for full 7 days even if the test is negative. And if the test is positive or develop symptoms, then they should isolate themselves after arrival. Now let us see the update that they have made on October 30th in the exception criteria for children. Number one. Children who are unvaccinated and traveling with the fully vaccinated parents should provide an attestation to the airlines before boarding. And in the attestation, they should agree to take the viral test within 3 to 5 days on arrival. Number three, if they test positive or develop symptoms, then they should self-isolate. Number four, the parents or the guardian who are fully vaccinated and traveling with the unvaccinated kids, they can attest on behalf of their children. So this update is mainly on the quarantine section. Children need not quarantine for full 7 days as CDC felt that it is very difficult for the kids to quarantine after arrival. And parents or the guardian who are traveling with the children can attest on behalf of the children agreeing to take the viral test within 3 to 5 days after arrival and self-isolate if they test positive. The next update is from US Embassy India. The US Embassy India estimated that roughly 3 million visa holders who are fully vaccinated will be able to travel under the new travel policy starting November 8th. Which means visa holders, though they were holding a valid visa and fully vaccinated, but due to this national interest exception requirement, they were not able to travel. And of course, till November 7th, the existing travel guidelines will be in place. The next update or the heads up from the US Embassy India for the people who are planning to get their stamping in coming months is that we can expect significant appointment wait times for some non-immigrant visa categories. Consulate have already highlighted that even if the new travel policy is announced, the consulate operations still remains in a limited fashion, which means right now they are not planning to resume their regular operations. So if you are one among the applicants who are waiting to schedule your appointment in next couple of months, then don't wait for the consulate update, which is expected in next couple of days. Instead, start checking for slots right now, because the consulate will not give an announcement before opening the slot. Usually, the consulate open the slots for the visa category and then they announce it via Twitter or Facebook or through Visa Fridays. But by the time you check after the announcement, the slots might have got filled up. So try getting your slots right now. And one more point to be noted is the visa priority need not be the same as like past couple of months, because the people who have received 221G will be in the queue along with F1, work visa, B1, B2, R visa, O visa and immigrant visa and other visa categories as well. So try booking your slots as soon as possible. And for the people who are planning to travel from US to India in the next couple of months, then keep all this in mind so that your travel plan is clear. So these are the updates that we have for today on the new travel policy and embassy updates. And few more updates are expected in next couple of days from consulate. For that, please stay tuned with Purna Arthi Vlog for more and more updates on embassy, immigration, travel and vlogs. Stay healthy, stay safe, take care. Bye-bye.